Hey guys, Ant on the Tech Chap, and when it comes to buying a new laptop, there's a lot to think about and it all gets very complicated very quickly. So hopefully these tips will make things a little bit easier when it comes to buying your next laptop, but I have also put links to some of my recommended models which I'll keep updating over time in the description below. And also a big thank you to Surfshark VPN for sponsoring this video. Okay, so let's get into it. And the first thing to think about is, do you want a laptop that runs Windows, macOS, or Chrome OS? You probably already know the answer to this, and most of the time it's whatever you're used to using. If you've always used Macs and maybe have an iPhone or iPad, then yeah, a MacBook Air or Pro with iMessage and AirDrop will be best. They're beautiful laptops and easy to use, but they can be very expensive and you don't have that many options. Windows 10 laptops are great as you have a much bigger range to choose from for all budgets, from thin and light Ultrabooks to workstations to gaming laptops. Then there's Chromebooks, which run on Google's cloud-based Chrome OS. These are really popular with students as they're usually much cheaper and they act more as a terminal for accessing apps in the cloud like Google Docs, Dropbox, and of course the web browser. Despite what you read in the comments, there really is no right or wrong answer here, it depends on you. But if you're a student on a tight budget or just want a basic laptop to access the web, then consider a Chromebook. If you want a premium laptop and you have at least $1,000 to spend, then maybe consider a MacBook Air. But I think for most people, the safest bet is a Windows 10 laptop, just because of the sheer range of devices on the market. Now, despite what you may have heard, it is actually all about size and shape. This doesn't sound right. Size and form factor. Laptops like the Microsoft Surface Pro 7 and Lenovo Yoga C940 offer better tablet experiences with detachable keyboards or 360-degree hinges that can be flipped round. These are usually more expensive and more suited for mobile rather than power users though. Most laptops though still use a traditional clamshell design with sizes ranging anything from 11 to 17 inches. It's pretty straightforward that generally the smaller the screen, the lighter and more portable the laptop is, while bigger 15-inch laptops are more likely to have the option of higher power processors and dedicated graphics cards. There are some outliers though, like the LG Gram 17 with a huge screen and super lightweight body. It is expensive though, and it uses lower power processors that you'd usually find in a 13-inch laptop. Some laptops also have touchscreens, and I think hybrid 2-in-1s are best for this, as they'll usually support a stylus or a pen, which is great for artists and designers. I think for me, a touchscreen is a nice extra, but not really essential, and usually I'm trying to avoid getting my dirty fingerprints all over the screen anyway. Now just quickly, I'm sure you're sick to death of hearing about VPN providers, but I do want to tell you about Surfshark VPN, who are very kindly sponsoring this video and offering you guys an exclusive deal of 83% off and 3 months free. Surfshark is the only VPN that lets you use one account for an unlimited number of devices, all your tech, wherever you are in the world. VPNs, or virtual private networks, protects your privacy when you're browsing. So even on public Wi-Fi in a coffee shop or hotel, using Surfshark VPN, you can browse safely, block ads, prevent tracking and data theft. And of course, access shows in different countries. So if you click the link in the description and enter the code TECHCHAP, you'll get 83% off plus an extra 3 months completely free. And they offer a 30-day money-back guarantee if you change your mind. So check out the link in the description below and give Surfshark a try. Speaking of the screen, we also need to consider resolution and, in the case of gaming laptops, refresh rate. Refresh rate or refresh rate? Refresh rate. I don't know. It's lost all meaning.
Small nitpick. Why do I have to put this stupid 1080p sticker on it? No one cares. I don't want to look at the stupid sticker on my laptop. It's on the demo. It's on for all the videos.
If that's your biggest criticism, I think we'll be right. The vast majority of laptops are 1080p, aka Full HD, and to be honest, for 95% of us, that's perfect. But more and more higher-end laptops now offer a 4K option, which means the screen is a lot sharper, there's more pixels per inch. And because of the higher quality panels, usually they're more color accurate as well, so ideal for video and photo editing. Most good reviewers though will include a screen's sRGB, Adobe RGB, or P3 color ratings in their review. The higher the better, but if you are doing color accurate work, then make sure you check before you buy a laptop. Back to 4K though, and the biggest downside, other than being a bit more expensive usually, is it has a massive impact on your battery life. Usually you'll only get about half or maybe two-thirds of the battery that you would otherwise with a 1080p screen. It is a big difference. Also, it significantly lowers your frame rate in games, as the laptop has to push millions more pixels. So for gaming laptops, I think the best combo right now is a 15-inch screen with a 1080p resolution, and if possible, a higher 120 or 144Hz refresh rate. This'll help everything look and feel a lot smoother. Okay, let's talk about specs. And this is where things get a bit more technical. But stay with me, and hopefully I won't bore you to death. Although, I'm not making any promises. A basic guide will be to look for either an Intel i5 or i7 processor, 8 gigs of RAM, 256 gigs of SSD storage, and if you're doing more intense graphical work or gaming, a dedicated graphics card. That spec will be about right for most people, although the more RAM and storage, the better, if you can afford it. So that's pretty high level, but I want to dive just a little bit deeper into processors or CPUs. When it comes to laptops, Intel pretty much dominate the market right now, although there are some good budget options with AMD chips. But for simplicity, I'll stick with Intel here. The thing is, it's easy just to go and say, go and get a laptop with an i5 processor. And while that's broadly a good recommendation, there's a couple of things you need to think about because they're not all made equal. Firstly, what generation is it? And secondly, what letter is in the suffix? Right now, so at the end of 2019, we're on 10th generation U series processors and 9th generation H series processors. Those letters are really important though, because when you look at a processor model name, right at the end there will be a letter, a suffix, and usually it's either U or H or HK, and that tells you a lot about how powerful that processor is. U chips are found on smaller 13 and 14 inch laptops, whereas H or HK processors offer much better performance, and you'll find them in 15 inch and bigger laptops. So if you are going to be running more intensive applications, then go for a laptop with an H series chip. From processors to graphics, and the vast majority of laptops actually just use an integrated graphics chip. They don't have a dedicated card. And that's fine for basic tasks like streaming video, maybe doing some very light photo editing, but anything beyond that, they're pretty terrible. Although, actually, Intel's latest 10th generation Ice Lake processors that come with what's called Iris Plus graphics are actually a big step up, and so we're seeing integrated graphics get a bit better. But really, if you want to do anything graphically intensive, whether it's video editing or playing games, then you're gonna want to get a dedicated graphics card. At the bottom end, you have the likes of NVIDIA's MX150 or 250 chips, typically in smaller 13 or 14 inch laptops. You'll be able to play basic games on low to medium settings, and it's fine for full HD video editing. For anything more serious, look for something like an NVIDIA GTX 10 series or more powerful RTX 20 series cards. And finally, if you are looking to get a gaming laptop, there's something called Max-Q which you should look out for. Sometimes you'll find a RTX 2080 Max-Q, for example, and that's a slightly less powerful version, usually about 15% less, and offers a better balance between performance and battery life. So I would recommend a Max-Q card for all but the most hardcore of gamers. Just a quick mention of RAM and storage. This is a little bit simpler because essentially, the more the better really. So ideally look for 8 or even 16 gigabytes. This will let you have more Chrome tabs or programs open at once without it starting to chug and slow down. It's not quite as important for gamers, but editors or graphic designers should aim for 16 or maybe even 32 gigs if you've got the budget. As for storage, well, obviously the bigger the better. It means you have more room for your files and games and videos and other things. But actually, the most important thing, one thing to take away from this video, if nothing else, is to make sure that your laptop has an SSD or solid state drive. This makes such a difference to how fast it boots up, how quickly apps load, and the general responsiveness of your laptop. Usually you'll get 128, 256, or 512 gig options. Cheaper laptops may still have hard drives or HDDs. Try to avoid these unless you see Intel Optane mentioned or something called an SSHD. These are kind of hybrids and offer a decent balance between speed and storage space. Hopefully you guys haven't fallen asleep just yet. We are nearly there, I promise, but just a quick mention of ports. And to keep things simple, honestly, going forward, if you're buying a new laptop, there's just one you need to consider really, and that's USB-C. And ideally one that supports Thunderbolt 3, which is the fastest kind of USB. Usually you'll see a Lightning logo next to it, but have a look in the specs before you buy. So Thunderbolt 3 USB-C ports are what you find on MacBook Air and MacBook Pros. In fact, that's all they have, which can be a bit frustrating, so you have to buy adapters. So while older USB Type-A's, HDMI's, card readers, they're all handy and most Windows laptops have a good range, going forward, USB-C will be ubiquitous. Mid to high-end laptops usually do have Thunderbolt 3, although some, like the latest Microsoft Surface Laptop 3, has USB-C but not Thunderbolt 3, which I think is a bit short-sighted, especially given the price. Now, when it comes to battery life, unfortunately, you can't really take the manufacturer's claim as gospel because until very recently, like almost pretty much this last few months, laptop manufacturers have just been doing local video playback with brightness turned down, Wi-Fi off to test it. So it's not really a real world use. So if you see a laptop, say it has 12 hours of battery in the tech specs, in reality, you're looking at probably more like 7 or 8, although of course it comes down to how you use it. When buying a laptop, it's always a trade-off between performance and battery life. Most laptops these days will give you at least 6 hours of real-world use, so you can't go too wrong. And finally, tip number 10, and if all those specs seem like a lot to think about, which to be fair they are, then actually you may want to look out for something called Project Athena. It's a new Intel program, kind of like Ultrabook 2.0, where laptops have to meet a certain standard, a certain spec, like having the latest 10th gen processors, fast SSD storage, Thunderbolt 3, Wi-Fi 6, fast charging, instant on, lots of great features in order to be part of the Athena program. We're just now seeing the first wave of Project Athena laptops come out, and you may start to see this logo more often, but it's a great way to know without having to dive into all the tech specs that you're getting a high-end and future-proof laptop. The thing is, you can't really buy a bad laptop anymore. They're all variations of good and, of course, value for money. But if you're not sure, watch our reviews, ask us questions in the comments, and also go into the store and try it for yourself, because while it may tick all the boxes in terms of specs and display and size, you may actually end up hating the feel of the trackpad or the keyboard, or it may have a really cheap feeling chassis and the screen flexes and doesn't feel very nice. So all those sort of things are often difficult to quantify, so it's definitely worth watching reviews. And as I say, going into the store and just having a bit of a play with it yourself. So I've put links in the description for my current recommended laptops if you want to check them out. Once again, a big thank you to Surfshark VPN for sponsoring this video. Click the link below and you can get 83% off and 3 months free by using the code TECHCHAP when you check out. So if you want to surf the web securely and watch shows that you can't normally get in your country, then give Surfshark VPN a try, and with their 30-day money-back guarantee, there's no harm in giving it a go.